So have you ever been in the hospital and you're getting ready to be discharged and they start throwing around words like long term or subacute and respite care, and you're saying to yourself, I don't even know what that means. Well, you're like a lot of people then who don't know what those words mean. So stay tuned, because my guest today is going to explain it to all of us. Stay tuned. Hey, good morning, everyone, and welcome to the month of March. We finally got through February. Let's see how March goes for us. Hopefully, we're done with the snow. Well, my guest today is Shoshana Stein. She's from Laurel Bay. And Shoshana, why don't you take a moment, give a little brief introduction of who you are, and tell us about your role at Laurel Bay.
Hi there, Andrea. Good morning. Good morning, everyone. My name is Shoshana. Like Andrea mentioned, I'm the Director of Business Development at Laurel Bay Health and Rehab. We're a skilled nursing facility in the Bayshore area. And I basically am the one who you would speak to. You, I would be the first line of sight, first point person if someone's interested in coming to Laurel Bay. And I work with families and the community, educating them on what skilled nursing care is all about. And that's essentially what I do in a nutshell.
All right. Well, you're going to educate all of us today, because I think there is there's a lot of confusion. People simply don't know if it, you know, you've never had the experience of being in the hospital, or maybe you have. And they tell you that we're going to discharge you, you're going to go to a long-term care, or you need a subacute care. You don't even know what that means. So let's explain what those, well, let you explain, Shoshana. What do we mean by when we say subacute, rehab, long-term care? What does this all mean?
Okay, great question. I speak to families all the time. They're exactly what you just said, Andrea.
What is it?
Their loved one is in the hospital, and the discharge planner slash possibly the social worker starts speaking to them about subacute rehab. If you've never had that experience, you're wondering, okay, what are we talking about when someone says subacute rehab? Really, a hospital is an acute setting, and subacute would then be one step down, meaning that your loved one, or as we call them, our residents, will be receiving occupational therapy, physical therapy, and possible speech therapy. Someone's coming from a hospital setting and they need strengthening, and that they would be coming to a skilled nursing facility slash also known as a subacute rehab and be receiving those therapies in order to get better.
You're not exactly ready to go home yet, but you don't need as much as you're getting in a hospital. Right. So I like your definition. A hospital is acute care. That's a good way to look at it.
Right. So I would give it like that. Exactly. This is a step down. So they're coming. So you no longer need to be in a hospital setting, because that is where you're having care that's, you know, it's a high level of care.
Right.
This would be your step down, using also the word subacute as saying a step lower than acute care, a step lower than hospital setting, still receiving 24-hour care. So that means a nurse, there's a registered nurses, director of nursing, social work, rehab, activities. It's a full-fledged holistic approach. That's what we do at Laurel Bay, a holistic approach to healing and strengthening. And that's what they mean by subacute care. It is not long-term care. After the subacute stay, the resident will go back to their home-like setting. They'll go back to their house.
So Shoshana,
they'll get back to where they were prior to the hospital.
Prior to the hospital, right.
Right. They'll get back to their level of care prior to their hospital stay and then go home.
So now if you're in a subacute situation, how long, does that mean? I might be there for a week, a month, 2 weeks. What does that sort of imply?
Right. So when someone is admitted to a subacute setting, generally not the first day, but within somewhere between 48 to 72 hours, the facility will have an idea based on nursing care, based on the rehab department, how long they see that resident being in the facility and how long they feel that they'll need the rehab and the skilled level of care. There could be someone coming in for 6 weeks of antibiotics, then you know it's 6 weeks of IV antibiotics. But someone could be coming in Unfortunately, someone could have fractured their hip. And you know what? One person recovers in a week. Another person may take three weeks.
Okay.
So to give a definitive answer to that really wouldn't be honest. You'd have to be there. You'd have to get a clear picture from the rehab team and then really take it from there. So it could vary. That's the truth. It could vary.
That's a fair answer. Yeah.
Everyone heals differently. Everyone heals differently.
But when we say subacute, so we're implying that it's a short-term stay to get you back to where you were so that you can go home and resume life. Okay, that's a good way to look at it.
Subacute care is essentially saying short-term care. They're used interchangeable. Means the goal is to get back to home or get back to where you were living prior. It could be with a child, let's say. Just means it's a short-term stay. It's a short-term stay. Goals are to get back to base.
Okay.
Get back where you were.
So then when we say you're going to need some long-term care, how do we define that? Obviously, this is different. And maybe this is open-ended too.
Well, actually, this is an excellent question, Andrea. And we're going to we could divide it up, understand it easily with short-term care is that subacute stay, which is you need a few weeks of therapy, someone needs strengthening, someone needs to get back to their previous level of care. Long-term care would be that, we don't see really that the person is going to be able to get back to their home or to their prior living quarters, that they really do need that 24 hours of care. They need someone to help them with their activities of daily living. They need a nurse to administer medications. And really, they need that long-term care setting. And at Laurel Bay, we offer both. We have that subacute, we have people come in for short-term stays, and we also have people coming for long-term care stays. And that is in a nutshell of it all.
Okay.
Doesn't mean someone may come in for long-term care. All of a sudden they're getting so much better being in this setting, they could go home. But generally long-term care means they're there for a longer duration.
All right.
And they need that care.
All right. And so what we always say when we on Scan FYI, I mean, this is about educating the public. This is for your information. So we think it's a great idea to know about places like Laurel Bay and the definition of subacute and long term in advance. It might not pertain to you today, right now, next week, next month. But if you do find yourself or a loved one in a situation, it's important to know what your options are, because if you don't make the choice, then somebody chooses for you, and nobody wants that. So if you wanted to know more about Laurel Bay, are you able to, Shoshana, can someone go there and check out the facility?
Definitely. So you bring up another great point, which is sometimes someone may find themselves in a hospital setting and the discharge planner is like, now choose three facilities that you want to go to. And
right now, just do it. Yeah.
Right now, you need to leave the hospital. We need to discharge you. Doctor wrote the discharge order. We're ready for you to go. People are standing there like, now what? I don't know.
And this is common.
I heard of this one, but I don't really know much about them. So I always make the recommendation is go on tour. Call them up. As you would, let's say you would call our facility, Laurel Bay, you'd call me if you had my number, and we would just set up for a tour right away. We're always available for tours, and you just walk in. You could walk in and say, I'd love a tour. You don't even have to call. You could just say, you come in and say, I'd like to tour the facility. I have a loved one who's in the hospital. I need placement. And then take a tour. And sometimes even what I would recommend is those spot tours, no previous call, nothing. You're just walking in there. No one's anticipating that you're coming. You are just walking in and seeing what the feel of the facility is. And that's a great way to know what you're getting. And you'll get a vibe. You'll get a sense of what's going on there. And you'll also get a feel of the energy, which I think is important. The energy of the facility.
Absolutely. And again, I always think if you do this, maybe you live in the Bayshore area, so you would like to, if you need a subacute or a long-term, you want to be near home. So go to Laurel Bay or go to any place that's near you and check it out in advance so that you're not caught off guard when they say to you in the hospital, where do you want to go? Right now, you're leaving in an hour. That happens, guys. That happens.
Yeah, so I would definitely, if I had, you know, what my advice would be is if you do have a loved one that's in the hospital, yeah, be proactive. Go check out a few places definitely. That are local that you think you'll be easy to visit. You know, you don't want to choose a place that's an hour away and then you're never going to be, you know, it's going to be hard for you to visit. Look around at the places around and, you know, obviously you're looking for good care. That's the number one thing that you're looking for.
So first of all, let me remind everyone out there listening, I will put Shoshana's info and the info for Laurel Bay. It'll be in all the comments. So if you do want to reach out to her, we'll make it really easy for you. So when somebody is going to taking a tour, and that sounds kind of a funny way to phrase it, but it is a tour. What should they be looking for in any location? What do you feel like you're going to notice right away?
Okay, right away, what I think you would notice is the energy of the building, honestly. How do the staff members interact with one another? Remember, this is a team. It's a team approach. It's an interdisciplinary team approach, which means all of the departments have to work together right. in order to get mom, dad, aunt, uncle, loved one, friend back to the way they were. And to also make them feel comfortable, make them feel cared for. It should be a warm setting. So right away, as you're walking those halls and peeking in, try to get a sense of what's going on. Is everyone getting along here? Do people say hello? Do they say hello? Do they greet one another? So I think that that's a really important part. And an obvious one would be the clinical care, meaning, is this a good nursing facility? Do you speak to the nurses? Hey guys, do you like it here? How's it, you know, what's going on? You could even speak to some of the residents. If you feel that comfortability and feel that comfort level that you're able to engage with them. And I would, you know, I feel like online research is nice and it's good, but just remember it's a snapshot of when, you know, when, where things are. So again, walking in yourself and just walking around and speaking with the people really does help. And you're looking for a warm, caring, and highly clinical level building. That's what you're looking for. And results. How, if you're looking for that subacute right. rehab / short term, how fast does mom and dad, what's your general, like you had asked in the beginning, give me a ballpark. So again, it could be a week to 20 days or what have you, but get and look for honest answers. Like what I'm saying is the truth. So this is, you want real answers. You don't want that bogus stuff. You know, everyone's back to themselves and it's no big deal. You know, it's you want something real. So that's what my recommendation would be.
So don't be afraid to go to any location near you and check it out for yourself. And I like that. Ask questions, poke around, ask questions. I do think it is a great idea to talk to the staff. Are they happy there? That's always an interesting indication of what's going on. Yeah.
And I'll add to that, actually, also, I would also, you know, inquire, how long has your director of nursing been here? How long do you generally, let's say we call it an ASAN, assistant director of nursing. If you see a lot of turnover in a building between nursing aides, certified nurses aides, RNs, director of nursing, that would be something that I'd be like, why is everyone coming and going so fast? I know at Laurel Bay, Laurel Bay, our director of nursing has been there for over 20 years. She was a charge, she was a CNA, then she went to charge nurse, went to school. She worked her way up. I mean, she has a love for those residents, a real strong love. She has Christmas lists of their wishes already in her, posted on in her office. So these are things that, you know, you don't find everywhere. So I like the longevity. I think the longevity of people staying, staff staying in the same facility says a lot.
I agree. And, you know, honestly, in any employment situation, the fact if the staff is there for a long time, that does say something. Yeah.
It does. It really, really does.
You know what? The last thing that we want to talk about is I want to talk about what does it mean for respite? I think that's another one of those words that we hear, and we might know what it means, but what does it mean in, you know, in terms of In terms of like this situation with a place like Laurel Bay. So explain that if you would, Shoshana.
Okay. So a respite really, the definition is kind of like a reprieve.
Yeah.
You know, let's take a step back. I need a rest almost. That's what it is. I need a break. And that's what it is.
But who is the break for?
That's exactly. So the break is really for the caretakers. So I'll use myself as an example. I'm taking care of my mother. She lives with me and we're busy. I'm busy with her all day. Or let's say during the day she's occupied and has an aide that's there, but I'm taking care of her at night. Now I want to go on vacation or I have burnout, which is completely normal, which is I need a break. I need a break. So a great idea and something that is done often, but people don't necessarily think of this, is having their loved one come to a skilled nursing facility or come to Laurel Bay. We have it all the time for 5 days, seven days, a month. We're going on vacation for 2 weeks in August. And can my mom come here? So we have certain steps that you have to follow in order for mom to be admitted. But it's a great way for caretakers to take that little time that they need so they could even be better caretakers or they could do a great job. Being a caretaker is hard. It is hard, hard work. It's tiresome. It could be draining, even though you're madly in love with your mom. But it could wear you down. And that respite stay, which is something we offer, will give you that break. We'll give that, you know, that caretaker the break. And they'll know that their loved one is being taken care of in the best way possible. So it's really great.
You know what? That's an important point because you don't want to feel guilty that you're doing this respite. Caregiver burnout is real. It's a terrible thing to experience. And this is a way of, taking care of the caregiver. Without feeling guilty, you should not feel guilty or bad about putting someone that you love in a situation like Laurel Bay so that you can give yourself a break. I agree with you, Shoshana, because then everyone comes back a little refreshed. And chances are your loved one could use a break too.
Yes, you know, it's actually interesting.
Yeah.
Very often families will come and say, okay, mom, she could be a little difficult. She could be a little demanding. And it's interesting, obviously, because everyone at Laurel Bay is well-trained. This is their profession. This is what they do. And you must have a love for it if you're going to be in the facility. So, and their mom is great. Like we don't see it. You know, it's like the nurse, a baby nurse saying, oh, your baby didn't cry at all.
Because mom needed it.
All of a sudden, you know, so you'd be surprised that mommy even had the greatest experience ever and love being at Laurel Bay saying, you know, oh, I had a great time here. We've had people come for respite stays. And after a certain amount of time, a year later, 2 years later, mom's coming back for long-term care because things mm-hmm. progress. So it's really, and like you said, Andrea, it's really, you're doing it's beneficial for everyone all around.
Yeah. I think very often the person you're taking care of, believe it or not, they can use a break from you. We don't always think about
I think
there is a lot of truth to that. Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, they could take a break from you. You could take a break from them. Know that they're being well cared for.
Exactly.
You know that they're being well cared for, and you could go on your vacation or you could do a staycation. Whatever you do, you could get that break to
absolutely
that you need, that we all need. We're human beings. So everyone needs it. And it's something that we offer. So we basically span the gamut. We offer respite care, subacute rehab, which we said is that short-term care portion, and long-term care.
I think we learned a lot today. I know I did. And Shoshana, thank you for really explaining very well what those terms mean, because at some point, we're all going to run into them. We just are. Or it's just part of, you know, the aging process, whether it's for you or for a loved one. And again, don't be afraid to take advantage of respite care. It's good for everyone.
Yeah, it is good for everyone. And we actually have a community hotline where anyone from the community could give us a call or email us with any questions you may have. It doesn't have to be specific to Laurel Bay. It could be just about the whole concept of skilled nursing care, long-term care, short-term care. So don't think just you listen to this radio show and now we're done.
Shoshana, what is that hotline number? Because I will make sure that I put it out there.
Okay, you could call 973-868-9701, and that will be my direct cell phone number. I love to answer questions and to educate the community and people out there who may have, you know, just simple questions or complicated questions. There are a lot of stuff when it comes to putting a loved one, when you move on to that next stage and you feel it's time that they need to be in this kind of environment. And I'm here. I'm here.
Okay.
And my colleague Hannah's here. We're all here to support you guys.
Well, Shoshana Stein from Laurel Bay Health and Rehab in the Bayshore area, thank you so much for being my guest today and really sharing some excellent information, defining some terms that we weren't really sure what they were, but now we know. Thank you.
My pleasure. My pleasure, okay. Andrea. Have a great day.
So remember out there, if it's important to you, it's important to us. I'm Andrea Tarr. We'll see you next time on Scan FYI. Bye, everyone. Bye, Shoshana. Take care.